Well, happening right now, the phone lines are open. If you or a loved one is suffering from a mental illness or have questions about symptoms, relief, or insurance, we've teamed up with Wellstone Behavioral Health to help out. The phone lines are open right now through 6 p.m., 533-8609.
This is Home. Way 31 Hometown News starts now.
Good Friday morning. Thank you for joining us. I'm Erin Daisy.
And I'm Justin McFarland. We're going to take you live to our Call Bank Center in just a few moments. But before we get to that, let's talk to Liz Cosgrove. She's got to look at the great forecast.
Oh, yeah. The sun is already rising up across parts of the Tennessee Valley, including Gunnersville, seeing a nice start to our day as temperatures are anywhere from 13 to 22 degrees warmer from where we were sitting yesterday morning. At 6 o'clock, we're at 46 for our friends into Fort Payne, 45 for Albertville, 50 for the Muscle Shoals and Russellville. And our warm spot is 52 up into Waynesboro. As winds are turning in from the south, they're a little breezy this morning, moving in at 5 to 15 miles per hour, but that's what's helping to usher in this warmer air. And before you know it, we'll go from the upper 40s and lower 50s this morning for the bus stop forecast into the upper 60s, and maybe a few spots will be into the lower 70s out near the shoals. The winds will be breezy all day long, but still a beautiful day. Try to get out there and enjoy it before the clouds and the rain move back in for this weekend. We'll talk more about our next incoming storm system on the way in just a few minutes. We'll send it back over to Erin and Justin.
Thank you, Liz. It is 6:02. Joshua Senegal is keeping an eye on the roads for us for your Friday morning commute. Let's check in with him. He's in the Way 31 Traffic Center. Good morning, Josh.
Good morning, Erin, and good morning, Justin. Things are clear for right now as far as accidents. We do have several road closures you're going to keep an eye out for. The main one is going to be on Martin Road. The lane that takes you from Martin Road to the northbound Memorial Parkway is going to be closed this morning from 8 o'clock until 11. Crews will be out there moving utility poles, so certainly keep that in mind. You see indicated here on our map the ramp that takes you from Southbound Parkway to West Martin Road is still going to be open, but this ramp will be closed. We do also have several other lane closures across the valley that you want to keep an eye out for in Huntsville, or in Madison rather. We have Waltriana Highway from Eastview Drive to Browns Ferry Road. That construction or that work is going to end today. And in Huntsville, the school zone on Whitesburg Drive is going to be expanding south, and then also some road work taking place in Athens and Decatur. We will continue to keep an eye on things for you throughout the remainder of the morning and keep you up to date on anything else that could impact your commute. Send it back to Erin and Justin in the studio.
Thank you, Joshua. 6:03, your voice, your vote. Presidential candidates are ramping up for a big weekend.
Voters head to the polls in South Carolina in their Republican presidential primary in less than 24 hours. And on that very same day, Democrats face off in the Nevada caucuses.
Systemic racism. We've got to go after the barriers that some states are trying to put up to prevent people from voting.
I was arrested when I was 22 years old. You know what I was arrested for? Fighting segregation.
Meanwhile, the Republican contest is getting ugly ahead of Saturday's South Carolina primary. Ted Cruz taking heat for a photoshopped picture depicting Marco Rubio shaking hands with President Obama.
He has a problem with the truth. And even Marco Rubio, I guess today there was something about he was, you know, picture was manufactured. I looked at that photo. I said immediately it was photoshopped.
Well, recent polling shows Donald Trump with a sizable lead in South Carolina, while Clinton and Sanders are running neck and neck in Nevada.
From Way 31's Decatur newsroom, an all clear is given after a bomb threat at Athens High School. Officials say the threat came into the front office yesterday. Staff acted quickly to get all students out of the building. Parents and guardians were allowed to check them out of school early. Administrators say they're thankful for the quick response by the Athens Police Department.
We have no choice but to err on the side of caution, to make sure that we don't put students or staff in harm's way. So, and I think the people that do these things know that we'll do that. We'll always err on the side of caution.
Nothing suspicious was found. Investigators say the incident is under investigation, and they do have a lead. Last fall, the school system had similar threats. Two there at Athens High School and one at the elementary school. Administrators say school will begin at the regular time this morning.
6:04 is the time, and a group of Huntsville people are pushing for the city leaders to raise the minimum wage to $10.10 an hour. But opponents say that would hurt the economy. Supporters of the Raise the Wage movement gathered outside of Huntsville City Hall last night. Workers who make minimum wage now say they just want to be able to pay their bills. Alabama uses the federal minimum wage right now, $7.25 an hour. But that number has not gone up since 2009, even though the cost of living certainly has during that time.
It's not fair to not be able to buy groceries when I go to the store and have to put things back because I don't have enough to get everything. I just want us to be able to buy the necessities.
There is a bill that's making its way through the Alabama legislature that would keep cities from voting on their own minimum wages.
The Madison County Board of Education voted against plans for a new Monrovia High School. This week, Superintendent Matt Massey laid out his plan for the new school in Monrovia, which would host 11th and 12th graders. Sparkman High School would host 9th and 10th graders. Last night, though, board members voted on a resolution saying they do not approve of the split.
It's time to move forward. Let's go submit to the DOJ, build the school for 9 through 12, a proven configuration. And I like what the school board did tonight. They said this is, they're not for it. They voted a resolution tonight saying they do not approve of the split configuration. It's going to take large class, a large senior, junior class, and move it from one campus to another.
The plan would also have to be approved by the Department of Justice, as referenced there. The Madison County School District is under a desegregation order, just like Huntsville City Schools, from the Department of Justice. Way 31 is helping you navigate the mental health maze. We have phone lines open right now for you to call and get any help or advice you need.
Meredith Wood is live with the counselors this morning. Meredith, what can you tell us?
Hey, Justin and Aaron, thanks so much. Well, throughout February, we are focusing on mental health and some of the problems and issues that patients and their families go through as they try to navigate this maze. And today, we're here to help. That's why we have the Mental Health Maze going on all day. The phone lines just opened up. They'll be open until 6 o'clock tonight. So anyone with questions, whether it's you yourself dealing with a mental health issue or you're a family member of someone and you just need a little bit of guidance, we've got professionals that are standing by ready to help you. Let's bring on in Brian Davis here. He is the CEO at Wellstone Behavioral Center, who's helping us out here today. Come on closer, I promise I don't bite. So this is a really important thing. Obviously, mental health is something a lot of people are scared to talk about. And when people get a diagnosis or they're concerned that they may have something or a family member that has an issue, they don't know where to turn.
That's correct. The research says that 1 in 4 of the general population will have a diagnosable mental health disorder in any given year. So 1 in 4 is a lot of folks. It's a common issue, but unfortunately, 2/3 of those people will not get the help that they need. And the biggest reason still, unfortunately, is stigma. They're embarrassed, they don't know where to start. And so hotlines like this are a great way to start. We've got resources, information we can direct people to. And make sure that they are able to connect with someone who can help them.
And people don't need to be afraid to talk to a professional. A lot of these are very treatable, very, you know, a little bit of talking goes a long way with a lot of these. So it's not something you need to be scared of or embarrassed about.
That's correct. Treatment works. I mean, that's the bottom line. But you have to reach out and talk to someone to get that started. You know, we see a lot of folks where we talk about recovery. And that means even if I'm dealing with something that doesn't just magically go away, I learn how to cope with it. And everyone has coping skills. Our job is to help them find those and strengthen them and build on them.
All right. Well, Brian, thanks so much. He'll be here answering phones, as well as we've got three other people in the banks. Actually, the phones just started ringing as soon as we started talking to Brian. So if you have a question, do not hesitate to give us a call. They will be talking to you. It will be confidential. And we hope that we can help a lot of people throughout the course of the day. Aaron and Justin.
Thank you very much, Meredith. It is 6:09 on your Friday morning.
Well, coming up on We 31 Hometown News, a bus driver is in big trouble after a near miss that's caught on camera. We'll tell you more about that, but first, let's check in with Liz.
Well, I'm not in trouble here in the Weather Center. We're going to see a gorgeous day for our Friday. We'll talk more about that nice weather in just a few minutes.
I was headed to the grocery store. I was in a wreck with my children. An 18-wheeler hit us. I knew I needed help, so I turned to attorney Alexander Shannara.
If you've been injured in an accident, call me, Alabama. Unclaimed freight notice this weekend at American Freight. Over 1,000 truckloads of living room furniture. Seven-piece living room groups that include a sofa, love seat, coffee table, two end tables, and two designer lamps. You get all seven pieces from only $398 complete. Free layaway till tax refund. Same-day delivery. Come to the loading docks this weekend only at American Freight in Huntsville at 2518 North Memorial Parkway, 1 mile north of University Drive. Phone 519-8555.
Honey, did some Captain D's make you feel better?
Yeah.
When you love seafood this much...
Back again?
I hope it's just a clumsy phase.
It's gotta be D's. Anything's worth it for our new Hush Puppy fish tenders or two-piece catfish. Also, try our grilled menu featuring new crab top tilapia. For full meals starting at just $4.99, it's gotta be D's.
Satellite and telephone companies complicate deals with contracts and hidden fees. But with Spectrum Triple Play, we keep it simple and affordable. TV, internet, and voice for $29.99 a month each, all with no contracts.
Finally,
who wants a contract?
With Spectrum TV, you get your favorite HD channels free, and all your primetime shows are free on demand to watch instantly.
On demand is amazing for binge watching.
We can always watch what we want, when we want it.
With the Spectrum TV app, we can watch TV anywhere.
Get Spectrum TV for $29.99 a month. Call 844-321-2999. And Spectrum Internet is simply the fastest you can get at 20 times the speed of DSL.
A lot more reliable than any other service I've had.
Our phones, tablets, all connected.
And it's fast.
And Spectrum Voice is simply superior with unlimited nationwide calling.
The fact that we bundle dropped our bill in half.
Get TV, internet, and voice for $29.99 a month each. Call 844-321-2999.
It was Friday, and I picked up my friends after class. We never expected to be in a wreck. I called attorney Alexander Shannara. Mr. Shannara helped me.
If you've been injured in an accident, call me, Alabama.
Brought to you by Pleasures Romance Boutique.
It's 13 minutes past 6 a.m. on what is going to be a gorgeous Friday. So it's on us if we don't get out and enjoy this weather and soak up the sun because, wow, we've got a stubborn weather system coming in with rain and clouds, right?
Mm-hmm. Those clouds aren't going to budge for the next 6 days. 6 days of gloomy weather. I know, that sounds actually really sad.
It's going to fly by, trust us, it'll be fine.
So make sure you get an ample dose of vitamin D today, soak up that sunshine and enjoy it because we're going to be well above average today and we deserve it. February's been a pretty chilly month. We're already kicking off temperatures this morning at 50 degrees. So our friends into the Scumbia starting to see the sun rising up over Huntsville, another beautiful sunrise. This time it's warmer, so you can actually take your cup of coffee, sit outside and enjoy it. We're into the upper 40s and the same for Decatur, 47 degrees with another beautiful sunrise over the Tennessee River. That's my favorite webcam. The out-the-door forecast will be at 54 degrees by 8 o'clock this morning and warming up into the mid-60s by noon today. So you know that most places will be into the upper 60s and maybe a few 70s out there for our friends in the Shoals by this afternoon. The only downside with this sunny weather is that the pollen count goes up for juniper, maple, and elm. So make sure you take that allergy medicine. If you didn't do so last night, you will need it. Otherwise, you're going to start to sneeze and itch your nose a lot. As winds turn in from the south, we'll warm up into the upper 60s, lower 70s. Today, plenty of sunshine to go around. Cloud cover, though, moves on in for tonight. That'll keep things mild, but it's also going to keep us gloomy throughout the next 6 days in the forecast. A stalled out boundary to the north and west of us will produce a few spotty showers for Saturday afternoon. More heavier rain and a couple rumbles of thunder will be here by Sunday afternoon into Monday. Possibly an inch of rainfall is expected. We might see some minor ponding of water in the roadways. That's really our only concern with this system. Otherwise, two more systems move right in behind us on Tuesday and Wednesday. So that'll keep the cloud cover in and also give us a chance for another batch of rain showers for the middle of the work week next week. So today, it just sounds like a tropical heat wave, upper 60s, lower 70s. Mostly sunny skies. The only concern is the pollen count and a bit of a breeze that'll kick up from the south at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Wind gusts could reach as high as 30 miles per hour today. So just be careful with that, especially if you're a motorcycle. motorcycle driver. We have a lot of those watching us here at Way TV, so the winds are going to be a little breezy today. Otherwise, beautiful, 68 degrees for this evening before the sun sets at 5:34 tonight. Overnight lows, very mild, mid-50s, as clouds will increase and keep us nice and warm throughout the overnight. Good news is that you can save a lot of money on your heating bill throughout the next couple days. This will stay above average.
Ooh, sounds like a plan.
All right. Thank you so much, Liz.
Caught on tape, a tour helicopter in Hawaii crashed near the USS Arizona Memorial at Pearl Harbor. Look at that. How many people have been on those kinds of tours? Can you imagine? At least three people were hurt on this one. One is reportedly in critical condition. People who saw that crash jumped in the water and helped pull the victims to shore. It's not clear what caused it.
Well, a huge brush fire in Missouri is finally out this morning after burning more than 1,000 acres of land. A fire tornado was seen during that firefight thanks to high winds. A few buildings were also burned, but they were all abandoned in that case.
A Houston area school bus driver is now out of a job after a terrifying near-miss crash. A train nearly slammed into the back of her bus, which was full of high school students. The district says the driver did not follow standard protocol. Drivers must stop at least 15 feet from the track, open the door, look, and listen. The district says she was fired. The driver's daughter says her mom resigned.
Time right now is at 6:16 here on your Friday morning.
Coming up on Way 31 Hometown News, a cybersecurity analyst at UAH weighing in on Apple versus FBI.
And do you have questions about mental health and how to get relief? You can call the Way 31 Mental Health Hotline that's open right now.
You're everything I ever wanted.
Trip to the best town ever at ChattanoogaFun.com. Start by experiencing the Tennessee Aquarium, America's highest rated aquarium for guest satisfaction. The Tennessee Aquarium, downtown Chattanooga.
If you're spending the time to shop for the best price, it's time well spent at BobHembry.com. My name may be on the website, but it's our people at the dealership that make all the difference. Locally owned and Alabama proud, Truck Month has descended on Bob Hembry. Browse our great selection, choose your Silverado, or take advantage of select remaining 2015 Silverado crew cabs at $11,000 discounts. Bob Hembry Chevrolet, Guntersville. Earning your trust every single day.
I did it. Do it. Take the Nature's Bounty Hair, Skin, and Nails Challenge. If your hair, skin, and nails don't look more beautiful, we'll give you your money back.
I did it, and I feel beautiful.
Visit naturesbounty.com for details.
What do you think?
Let's get it.
Get lit. Mama needs something new. Get lit.
Right now at Big Lots, buy any Serta Perfect Sleeper mattress, get the matching box spring for just $10.
Shop Big Lots.
The Honda Pilot, judged best in class by KBB.
Star 99 has star power.
Love you like I'm gonna lose you.
Star 99.
Shut up and dance, don't you dare.
Today's best music, Star 99.
Tune in to Way 31 on Friday starting at 6 a.m. for the Mental Health Maze Hotline. You'll be able to speak with the qualified counselors from Wellstone Behavioral Health for free. The Way 31 Mental Health Maze Hotline, this Friday starting at 6 a.m.
Hey there, in today's Tech Bites, who's got the fastest wireless service?
One company crowned T-Mobile using apps downloaded by consumers. And in the latest test, another researcher says Verizon is tops based on its testing at various sites around the country.
An Indiana man is suing smart TV manufacturer Vizio. The class action lawsuit accuses the company of collecting personal data about his viewing habits and selling it to third parties such as advertisers or data brokers.
Vizio is facing similar legal challenges in other states. And a couple in Texas is in a legal fight with a company that it hired to watch its pets.
They weren't satisfied and posted a one-star review on Yelp. The company responded with a lawsuit and is seeking thousands of dollars because it says the couple violated its so-called non-disparagement clause.
Because there's such a thing. Who knew?
Who knew?
Those are your Tech Bites.
Have a great day.
It is 6:20. Way 31 has a finger on the pulse of the Rocket City and everything that makes our area tick.
Here's a roundup of your local beat, starting with RedstoneAlabama.com.
The Aviation and Missile Command has said goodbye to Major General Jim Richardson and welcomed their new commander, Brigadier General Doug Gabram. Major General Richardson will go to D.C. to be the director of the Army Quadrennial Defense Review Office in the office of the Deputy Chief of Staff. Way 31 spoke to Gabram right before he took command about potential challenges.
The budget and the decreasing resources, we know that. And I think Jim actually has put in a great plan, the 2025 plan, where we're looking at our core competencies and how we can do better in terms of goals, initiatives, and measures of performance. So I think we got a good plan in place. It's going to be some tough times, uncertain future, as we all look to the world.
If you would like to hear more about what both men had to say at yesterday's ceremony, you can watch the full speeches there at RedstoneAlabama.com.
News from TechAlabama.com this morning. A cybersecurity analyst at UAH is weighing in on the whole Apple versus the FBI case. Now, he says if the court rules for the FBI, it could forever change exactly how iPhones are designed. The FBI wants Apple to build a backdoor to access the iPhone 5C used by one of the San Bernardino terror shooters last year. The CEO of Apple, Tim Cook, says doing so could give hackers sensitive information to anyone who uses an iPhone. Tommy Morris with UAH says that if the FBI gets its way, you could see something different in the next iPhone 7.
The issue is if you let the camel's nose under the tent, per se, the government can come back not only on the 5C, but may require backdoors be designed in to future generations of the iPhone.
Morris does say this kind of backdoor would not affect the iPhone 6 because hardware is installed on it to prevent a backdoor from cracking the passcode.
From SpaceAlabama.com, we are waiting right now for a cargo craft to be released from the International Space Station. This is a live look from NASA TV.
From the open of the release
the spacecraft
window,
will burn up in the Earth's atmosphere over the Pacific Ocean. Astronaut Scott Kelly is in his last days aboard the International Space Station. His year-long mission will end March 1st. So cool. That's live.
It is incredible.
6:23 on your Friday morning.
Well, coming up on Way 31 Hometown News, the medication that you take for heartburn could be doing more harm than good. We'll explain.
And do you have questions about mental health, how to get relief, symptoms, even insurance? Way 31 has counselors standing by live right now to take your phone call. Here's the number, 256-533-8609.
Your down payment or tax refund up to $8,000 at University Kia. New 2016 Kia Souls are just $79 per month. And we want your trade. Get up to $8,000 over Kelley Blue Book fair market value for any trade. Only at University Kia.
Buy smart at iMart Express.
I love being able to buy and wear my glasses the same day. Why would anybody wait 2 weeks?
Two pairs start at $38.71 and two pairs with progressive lenses just $76.92. And you can wear your glasses today.
They have lots of choices at great prices. And oh, my glasses are ready. This time when I use my insurance, I got a second pair free.
Buy smart at iMart Express. Right now, use your insurance and get a second pair free.
In my business, Friday's payday. But I don't need a piece of paper. I need cash. We all started going to Redstone Federal Credit Union. Their check cashing is quick and simple. Compared to some other places, it's cheaper too. Paychecks, insurance checks, tax refunds, they'll even cash the big checks my boss gets when other places won't. So every payday, I go to Redstone Federal Credit Union to cash my checks. You should too.
For all your homeowners insurance needs, contact State Farm agent Tim Roberts in Huntsville.
No other storm shelter is safer. No other storm shelter has our unique anchoring system. Visit us on the web or come down to our interactive showroom. Nobody builds a better storm shelter. Valley Storm Shelters.
Some transitions happen gradually over time, but some can happen in an instant. In the unspoiled beauty of Gulf Shores and Orange Beach, where extraordinary adventures and expansive sugar-white beaches stretch on for mile after mile, it only takes a moment before you realize you're in a whole different state. Come, be transformed.
Double your down payment or tax refund up to $8,000 at University Kia. New 2016 Kia Souls are just $79 per month. And we want your trade. Get up to $8,000 over Kelley Blue Book fair market value for any trade. Only at University Kia.
Way 31 Traffic is brought to you by Charles Pittman. In a wreck? Need a check?
Charles Pittman is the way to go. Call 533-5000.
When your cold makes you wish you could stay in bed all day, you need the power of new Theraflu Express Max. New Theraflu Express Max, the power to feel better.
Some advice from the future. Don't buy makeup that settles into lines. It ages you. Get Simply Ageless makeup from CoverGirl and Olay. With B vitamins and SPF, it floats over lines and you look beautiful.
And now, there's Simply Ageless liquid makeup. It helps you look younger three ways.
So in the future, when you're older,
you look younger.
Simply Ageless from Olay.
And easy, pretty, beautiful CoverGirl.
Why are you singing the end?
Overlooking Huntsville and the Tennessee Valley from the top of Montesano. You're watching Way 31 Hometown News.
It is just about 6:30 here on this fantabulous Friday. I'm Justin McFarland.
And I'm Erin Dacey. We can't come up with enough good adjectives for this, and we need to soak up this sun because it's not going to stay here for long. Today's the day, right?
Yeah, fun Friday because you can spend all your time outside and enjoy it. So make sure you take advantage of it. We have 24 hours until the sun says goodbye to us, and we're already seeing a gorgeous sunrise this morning out into Bailey-Ton, Alabama. One of our weather watchers, Sherry, still reporting 47 degrees, much warmer than yesterday morning, and a beautiful sunrise at that all across the valley. We're at 48 for Rogersville, Oakland, 49 for Russellville, Florence, and Killen, 50 out into Waterloo and heading east of I-65. We're also at 50 for our friends up into Meridianville, 49 for Hightop and Holly Tree, 47 down into Cullman, and 46 for Rainsville and Fort Payne. Winds are a little breezy, but that's also helping to usher in that warmer weather, and away we go with temperatures today from 49 to 61 for your hiking forecast from 6 a.m. to 10 a.m. Let's send it back over to Erin and Justin.
Thank you so much, Liz. Let's check in right now with Joshua Senegal. He has got a look at your Friday morning drive. Pull out the sunglasses, Joshua.
Good morning, Justin, and good morning, Erin. We did just pick up on reports of an accident in Decatur at the intersection of 6th Avenue and West Moulton Street. No injuries are reported, but do certainly keep that in mind as you head out the door. It could cause some issues as far as the traffic flow there. We do also have a road closure that's going to be taking place this morning on Martin Road. The Martin Road ramp that takes you to northbound Memorial Parkway is going to close this morning from 8 o'clock until 11. Crews will be there removing some utility poles that will be in the way, so certainly keep that in mind. The ramp that takes you from southbound Parkway to West Martin Road will remain open, but you see here the ramp indicated here on the red line on your map will be closed from 8 o'clock this morning until 11. Apart from that, we are clear in the traffic center. We're going to continue to keep an eye on things for you, let you know about any other accidents or road closures that could impact your commute. Send it back to Erin and Justin in the studio.
Thank you, Joshua. Way 31 is helping you navigate the mental health maze. We have phone lines open right now for you to call and get any help or advice you might need.
Meredith Wood is live with the counselors right now and throughout this morning. Meredith, what can you tell us?
Hey, Justin and Erin. Yeah, the phones have actually been ringing pretty steadily here for the Mental Health Maze Hotline. With us now, we have Ashley Jones from Wellstone Behavioral Health. We ask her a few questions just about why this is something that's so important. I mean, we here all month long have been talking about this, and it's been ironic to us a little bit of how many mental health cases we've heard since this month started just across North Alabama. So what are some of the issues that y'all see the most of in Alabama and North Alabama?
We definitely see pervasively depression and anxiety symptoms. Those are some things that many are touched by or know someone touched by those symptoms. And so those are some things that often can be the starting point for a more significant mental illness.
There's been a lot of talk lately. Mental health facilities have lost a lot of funding. Some have been forced to close. There's issues with getting insurance to cover things. What are some of the problems that y'all see facing the patients and their families as they navigate through this maze?
Certainly resources is one of the primary challenges and difficulties. We also see stigma as a big challenge or difficulty for people feeling comfortable to speak up and stand up and reach out for help.
So a lot of people are hesitant to take that first step, and that's what today is all about, giving them that opportunity to ask those questions, get some help. I know y'all are looking forward to helping as many people as possible. So we've got the phone lines ringing right now. You can give a call if you've got a loved one that maybe needs some help, you yourself are feeling like you could use a little bit of some guidance, and the phone lines are open, so you can give a call. 533-8609 is the number to call, and they will be open until 6 o'clock tonight. Justin and Aaron.
Thank you, Meredith. Well, here's another problem many people face. It is heartburn.
Without a doubt, it normally happens at the worst possible time. And now doctors say some of the meds that we're taking to prevent heartburn could actually be hurting us. Way 31's Carla Fields is here with a long list of some of the other things that we could see as a result of these heartburn pills. Carla?
Right. And you just said the perfect thing right there, Justin. At the worst times. Happened to me yesterday. I was getting my hair done.
Oh,
heartburn
no.
kicked
in. The middle of the night.
Right.
And
out,
right?
That happens all the time, too. But there are some serious symptoms that go along that are associated with the medications that you take for heartburn. We're talking muscle cramps. We're talking pneumonia. We're also talking an increase for infections. And this is important. Dementia. Who knew that dementia would be associated with heartburn? It's really scary, the side effects of these medications. Now, this morning, according to researchers, once a person stops taking these pills, the amount of acid in their digestive system surges. It's believed that around 15 million people take PPIs like Nexium, Prilosec, and Prevacid. Now, according to this study, people who use these meds on a regular basis are at an increased rate for kidney disease and heart disease. It also increases your chances of being diagnosed with dementia by, get this, listen, guys, 44%. And at one point, these pills were only given out by a prescription, but now they're available over the counter, which means that more people have access to them.
Try a different kind of drug called an H2 blocker. These are drugs like Pepcid AC or Zantac. They generally cause fewer side effects and are less expensive than a PPI.
Now, we should also note that the study only looked at those 75 and older who use heartburn or medicine. And, Aaron, you were just mentioning a really good point, talking about Tums, Rolaids, those over-the-counter tablets that you can take, kind of a quick fix things.
Thing, yeah.
They're
yeah.
also included in this.
Really?
Now, they don't put you at risk for dementia, but doctors do so that they, if you take those, you get those other things like pneumonia. It makes your heart disease increase. So those are also
really?
Included in this. Risk. Not for dementia, but for those other ones. So kidney disease and heart disease are associated with those two. It's, who knew? And you said that you had an uncle who passed away from heartburn. It's almost as if it's unheard of.
Yeah, what happens is the acid in there just eats away at your esophagus and it causes cancer. It's called Barrett's esophagus. My dad was just recently checked just to make sure that he doesn't have that problem. So if you stop taking this medicine because of those risk factors, then what's going to happen? Are you putting yourself at a higher risk for cancer? So clearly, it's a doctor question if you take these, right? So are you going to go to your doctor about this?
Well, I depend on mine. Another problem is if you take these medications and you have another illness, which one do you take? You know, so it's kind of what can treat one thing can possibly cause another thing, and then you have to treat that thing. So it's kind of talk to your doctor if you have questions.
Don't be afraid to ask questions.
Exactly.
All right, thank you so much, Carla.
Well, several updates from our Sand Mountain newsroom. A woman is in Huntsville Hospital after a car wreck involving two other vehicles on Highway 72. The wreck happened near Cathedral Caverns. We don't yet know the name of the woman or how she's doing this morning, but we were told both her legs were broken in this wreck. An 18-wheeler and a pickup were also involved. State troopers are still trying to figure out what led up to the accident.
A section man in Jackson County is facing several charges this morning related to drugs. 33-year-old Buddy McCurry, it was arrested on Wednesday after Jackson County Sheriff's deputy served him a warrant at his home in section. Officials say they found meth, oxycodone, drug paraphernalia, and cash.
Way 31 now knows the identities of the three people killed in a Marshall County wreck yesterday. Alabama state troopers say the two-car accident happened on Alabama 69. 87-year-old Theodore Kaiser, 84-year-old Ann Kaiser, and 77-year-old Dillard Fortenberry all died in the crash. They were from Huntsville. 63-year-old Richard Queen of Gunnersville was also involved in the wreck, but he was not hurt. Officials are still investigating what caused that crash.
Well, an update now on Operation Nighthawk in Etowah County. 49 people have been arrested on 67 warrants. The operation is a joint effort between 14 local, state, and federal agencies. They did a warrant roundup on Wednesday night. In total, three of the 186 people wanted for 246 warrants. 80% of the warrants were for drug-related crimes.
Crowdfunding online is hugely popular. It's a popular way to raise money. A website called Inkshares allows anyone to become a published author through crowdfunding. Inkshares is allowing local author Micah Baker the opportunity to become published. However, one doesn't have to be a master writer. All you need is an idea. Once you have support for your idea, you can begin writing and taking pre-orders.
But you don't have to start off with a finished book. You can start off with an idea, a half-finished book, a few sentences in your book. Like, you can have a whole book if you want to.
Once you hit the milestone of 750 pre-orders, you can get a marketing campaign, an editor, a cover artist, and you can get your book published.
Interesting idea. From our Charles newsroom this morning, the Pegasus record store in Florence, which has been around for the last 36 years, might soon close for good. The owner, Eli Flippin, says that he plans to close at the end of March to spend more time with his family. He is selling the business and has had some interest, though so far he hasn't found a specific buyer, and he can't promise that the new owner will keep Pegasus in its current form.
And I'm really sad to see it closing because it's totally a landmark in North Alabama.
Some people we've talked to are actually looking at purchasing the business and possibly moving it to another location, maybe closer to downtown. So there's a lot of possibilities as to what can happen with it. But so far, everybody that we've talked to is pretty dead set on wanting to keep it the same.
If a new owner is not found by March 31st, then Flippin will close the store for good. Time right now is at 6:37 here on your Friday. Coming up on Way 31 Hometown News.
Local pastors taking on sensitive issues of race and faith. Stay with us.
Plus, do you have questions about mental health, how to get relief, symptoms, even insurance? We've got counselors standing by right now. 533-8609 in the Mental Health Maze Hotline.
I got hit by a drunk driver, and the insurance companies were not willing to work with me. I had to call Charles Pittman. He took it in his own hands, and I didn't have to do anything. He's a wonderful attorney.
Call 533-5000.
The world a president has to grapple with. Sometimes you can't even imagine. That's the job, and she's the one who's proven she can get it done. Securing a massive reduction in nuclear weapons, standing up against the abuse of women, protecting Social Security, expanding benefits for the National Guard, and winning health care for 8 million children. The presidency is the toughest job in the world, and she's the one who'll make a real difference for you.
I'm Hillary Clinton, and I approve this message.
Decatur's Home and Garden Show, presented by Gobblefied Lumber Company, is where you'll find the best builders, remodelers, furniture, and landscaping ideas. Lighting, flooring, windows, doors, and more. All local businesses eager to get to work on your dream home. Decatur's Home and Garden Show, Saturday, February 27th and Sunday, February 28th at Ingalls Harbor in Decatur. Stop dreaming. Start planning with our local experts at the Decatur Home and Garden Show, presented by Gobblefied Lumber Company.
I was driving in my Camry when I played the text.
When can I see you again?
I entered the location, 22 Beechwood Lane. The car rerouted me.
Turn left.
Told me where to go.
Turn right.
And I arrived 5.1 minutes later. Now, if only my car could tell me what to do next. Get a low 0% APR for 72 months on a new 2016 Toyota Camry. Toyota, let's go places.
Why travel all over the Tennessee Valley looking for jeans when the Pants Barn has jeans for everyone in your family all under one roof? All sizes, fits, and styles, including the hard-to-find big and tall sizes. Find the largest selection of Dockers, Levi's, Lee, Wrangler, and Carhartt jeans, as well as a large selection of men's and women's sportswear. So bring your family and get the right fit the first time. The Pants Barn, 2 miles north of Huntsville on the Parkway in Meridianville.
My car's been totaled. Who should I get?
Charles Pittman.
Good things can happen the moment you call.
I need an attorney. Who should I get?
Charles Pittman.
The attorney you call can make a difference.
Charles Pittman is the way to go. Call 533-5000.
The CRV, an SUV with 33 miles per gallon.
Is the time here on a fantastic Friday. Fantastic, fabulous, fantabulous, whatever you want to call it. Today gets everything because it is wonderful, Liz.
It's beautiful outside. The sun's already up. We're on the warmer side into the upper 40s and lower 50s. You can't beat it. Try to get outside and enjoy this nice weather. Taking a look at our webcam here from Barron Services facing the rocket. Beautiful pink and orange shadings in the sky as we're waking up at 6 o'clock this morning. Temperatures are anywhere from 13 to 23 degrees warmer from where we were yesterday, especially our friends in Winchester, Tennessee. Quite the change. We were at 27 at 6 o'clock in the morning yesterday. Now we're up to 48. 48 today with Scottsboro, 46 for Arab, 47 for Huntsville and Decatur, and a couple 50s still on the board for the Shoals and Moulton. As winds turn in from the south, that's what's going to drive in that warmer air today. A few places may reach to 70 degrees out into the Shoals and down into Coleman County. The rest of us upper 60s, which is more than 10 degrees above average. Sadly, though, we say goodbye to the sunshine. As higher pressure breaks down, our next storm system will be inching closer to us from the north and west. That's going to send in the cloud cover tonight and keep the chance of a few spotty showers in the forecast for Saturday. More rain builds in as we head into Sunday afternoon and into Monday. Over an inch of rainfall could occur, and we might get a couple rumbles of thunder with these showers too. So your pick this weekend will be Saturday because we have less of a chance of rain, but it's still not going to be as pretty as what we're going to see today. That cloud cover hangs tough even as we head into Monday and Tuesday. In fact, a whole new disturbance will build in for Tuesday and Wednesday of next week. So sadly, we stay with the gloomy and cloudy weather throughout the next 6 days in the forecast. So that's why we've been telling you to get outside and enjoy this beautiful weather. Hopefully you did yesterday. If not, you got one more day of it today. Upper 60s is the name of the game by this afternoon. It's going to be very pleasant, especially for the out to lunch forecast. We'll be into the mid-60s at that point. So try to enjoy some sunshine a little bit today. Heading into tonight with the cloud cover moving in, we'll stay mild, mid to lower 50s for overnight lows. And we'll stay into the 60s for Saturday and Sunday. We just welcome in the cloud cover and the chance of rain, particularly Sunday afternoon into Monday, is where you could pick up on a couple rumbles of thunder and heavier showers developing. Tuesday and Wednesday, two more systems will follow behind that, keeping the clouds and the rain threat in the forecast until we return to sunshine on Thursday.
Boy, beautiful looking forecast for today. However, in the next week, you know, you gotta take pictures. Go out and take selfies today. Yeah. So you can remember the good times.
Yeah, take your dog out for a walk, too. They're getting restless, aren't they? It is 6:43 on your Friday morning. Coming up on Way 31 Hometown News, Apple is now offering its own program to buy iPhones on installments.
And Facebook and Twitter side with Apple in an iPhone fight with the government. We'll explain.
Plus, do you have questions about mental health, how to get relief, symptoms, or even insurance? Way 31 has counselors standing by right now. Here's the number. Give us a call, 256-533-8609.
Save thousands now during Truck Month at Len Layton Chevrolet.
Choose from Alabama's largest selection.
All at the lowest prices.
New 2016 Silverado Double Cab, automatic and more, just $26,988.
For a limited time.
Only at Len Layton Chevrolet Decatur.
We don't have to look far to find real suffering. As disability attorneys, we see it in the life stories we defend each day. It's had a profound impact on me, the way I live my life, and the things I value most in it. We help people find the physical relief they deserve and the financial relief they need. If you feel your quality of life slipping away, we can help.
Hi, my name is Jan. As a nurse, I find it's usually a son
a daughter, or even a neighbor trying to care for someone. It's difficult. People in the hospital work shifts, but if you're a caregiver at home, you have to do it all. Caregivers get overwhelmed, but when we come in, we allow you to be the son or the daughter again, and we become the caregiver.
If you're struggling to care for a loved one, Gentiva Hospice may be the answer. Gentiva Hospice Care is part of your Medicare benefits and pays for supplies, medications, medical equipment, and nursing care visits for all eligible patients. Best of all, our care comes to you in the comfort of home. If you need help caring for someone you love, call 1-855-466-2761 today. That's 1-855-466-2761.
Save thousands during Truck Month at Lynn Layton Chevrolet.
Choose from Alabama's largest selection.
Save $11,000 off MSRP on new 2015 Silverado Crew Cabs. No dock fee, dealer prep, add only tax and title.
For a limited time.
At Lynn Layton Chevrolet, Decatur.
New grill, improved mileage. The 2016 Accord.
Apple is offering a program where you can pay in installments and then keep the phone rather than leasing it. The interest-free program with installments is similar to what major carriers now offer instead of two-year contracts and subsidized phones. The monthly tab for a phone depends on how old of a device you're trading in, but it could be as low as $14 a month if you were to trade in, say, 2014's iPhone 6 for the current iPhone 6S. Well, Facebook and Twitter siding with Apple in the public spat with the Obama administration over its refusal to help the FBI break into the iPhone of one of the San Bernardino shooters. Facebook pledged to fight aggressively against government efforts to weaken the security of consumer tech products. And Twitter said it stands with Apple and CEO Tim Cook. Well, the Surface Pro and the iPad Pro dragging the tablet market back from the abyss. According to calculations by IDC, devices with detachable keyboards now account for 1 in 5 tablets sold. Tablet sales have been struggling for a while. Consumers have been slow to replace them, and the big screen smartphones have eaten into sales. And many people who use Airbnb don't go back to hotels. The Goldman Sachs report says only 40% of people were likely to return to hotels after using Airbnb. That's compared to 79% of travelers who had not used the service, and they said they were likely to prefer formal lodging. From the NASDAQ market site in Times Square, I'm Jane King with your tech report.
6:47 is the time for Black History Month. Way 31 is highlighting some trailblazers who are making a real difference right here in the Tennessee Valley.
This morning, Way 31 is recognizing pastors Christian Cheers and Stephen Fincher. Both are tackling sensitive subjects of race and faith. They're doing it by hosting open discussions through what's called the Samaritan Project. This project is an experiment in getting people in Huntsville to reach across ethnic tensions to pursue friendships and reconciliation.
And we said, well, let's live this thing out practically and let's just talk about race and our differences. So that's kind of how it birthed and got formed, and it's been going ever since.
And so whatever angles we can use to open up that conversation, we've used MTV, like movies before. We talk about different clips, different things that are just going on in the conversation around America.
If you would like to participate in one of these conversations or learn more about the Samaritan Project, you can visit our website, waytv.com.
It's 6:48. Way 31 is helping you navigate the mental health maze. We do have phone lines open right now for you to call and get any help or advice you need.
Way 31's Meredith Wood is live with counselors right now. Good morning, Meredith.
Good morning, Aaron and Justin. Yes, the Mental Health Maze hotline is open. The phones have been ringing pretty consistently since we opened those up at 6 o'clock. We've got 4 people standing by to answer your questions, everything ranging from depression and anxiety to questions about dealing with insurance and how family members can cope. So there's a really wide array of questions that they're going to be fielding all day long. And it's a really important topic, something we've been focusing on all month long of February, just mental health and how patients can navigate through it, their families can navigate through it, because there's a lot of unanswered questions. People are sometimes scared to ask these questions to begin with. So we want to just help today and give you a platform to get some of these questions answered so you can get on the right path. The number to call is 533-8609. Again, the phone lines will be open until 6 o'clock tonight, so you've got plenty of time to call in, but don't waste this opportunity. It is a great chance for you to ask questions for yourself or for a family member or a friend, and they'll help set you straight on on the right path and get you the help that you or a family member needs. Erin and Justin.
Thank you, Meredith. It's great to hear those phones ringing this morning. Mm-hmm. It is 10 minutes before 7 a.m. Up next, we'll have the Way 31 Fastcast with all of your news headlines as you head out the door.
Plus, we'll get another check of your forecast and traffic as well. Good morning, America. Follows us right here on Way 31 Hometown News.
Here's a look at what's coming up on ABC.
Good morning. Coming up next here on Good Morning America, caught on camera, the terrifying moments. A tourist helicopter crashes into the ocean. This morning, we'll hear from the heroic witness who rushed to rescue the five passengers on board, all coming up next on GMA.
Starting Monday, GMA's going primetime with cameo appearances and hit ABC shows.
Hey, Tim Allen.
And we've got your exclusive backstage pass. So can Robin, Lara, and Amy go from news desk to actress?
Oh, you just called me an actress.
Next week on...
Good morning, America!
Hey, Billy, the man says your attic needs a lot more insulation. Luckily, Billy knows about the great attic insulation service offered by Bunsen Bennett Heating and Air Conditioning. And that's just what Billy needs to keep little Billy warm this winter. Bunsen Bennett, call us today.
Where will you find a great deal on a new truck with no bull? At Champion Chrysler Dodge Jeep and Ram in Athens.
That's right. It's Truck Month here at Champion, where you save over $10,000 on a brand new Ram truck. Or we have a Jeep Cherokee for only $19,990. To save a fistful of dollars, head up and move out to Champion. Drive like a champion at Champion Chrysler on Highway 72 in Athens, just 8 minutes from Madison or championathens.com.
No other storm shelter is safer. No other storm shelter has our unique anchoring system, competitively priced and manufactured here in Alabama. Valley Storm Shelters exceed FEMA requirements and have been tested by the Texas Tech National Wind Institute. We are a producer member of the National Storm Shelter Association. Visit us on the web or come down to our interactive showroom and see our flush mount and above ground shelters for yourself. Nobody builds a better storm shelter. Valley Storm Shelters.
You've upgraded all your old technology. So what about this? It's time to get into the new with Ford. Now get a Ford Fusion, Escape, or Focus with 0% financing for 60 months plus $2,000 trade assist cash. New is Ford, America's best-selling brand. Get into a Focus, Fusion, or Escape with 0 for 60 plus $2,000 trade assist cash. Only at your local Ford dealer.
Hey, Billy, looks like your home's gonna need a new heating system. Luckily, Billy knows about the fantastic deal being offered by Bunsen Bennett Heating and Air Conditioning. And it's just what Billy needs to keep little Billy warm this winter. Bunsen Bennett, call us today.
The 2016 Honda Odyssey is made in Alabama.
Log on to waytv.com and click Tennessee Valley Pros to discover Rocket City Insurance Group. Local agents representing multiple A-rated companies. Real agents right here at home. Rocket City Insurance Group, one of WayTV's Tennessee Valley Pros.
It's 6:53 and time for the Way 31 Fastcast. Police in Santa Ana, California say two suspects were shot and killed overnight after a burglary. According to authorities, officers responded to the burglary call and encountered at least four suspects. Officials say two of them were shot and killed by police. The other two were arrested. According to authorities, at least one gun was recovered at the scene.
President Barack Obama will be one of thousands of people who will say goodbye to U.S. Supreme Court Justice Antonin Scalia today. There will be a public viewing of his casket at the Supreme Court building tomorrow. There will be a mass funeral. Or a funeral mass, I should say, at a basilica in Washington, D.C.
New U.S. sanctions against North Korea are now law after the president signed off on them yesterday. Congress overwhelmingly passed this measure earlier this month. The sanctions are punishment for Kim Jong-un's regime. The measures freeze the assets of anyone doing business related to North Korea's nuclear or weapons programs.
Well, thousands of active duty troops suffer from post-traumatic stress disorder and depression. A new study says that the military is struggling to provide proper care for them. The study reviewed 40,000 cases. It found many troops with PTSD and depression are not getting the minimum number of therapy sessions needed.
A new study by the CDC says Alabama is one of the most sleep-deprived states in the country. These findings come from a random survey of more than 400,000 people nationwide. On average, only 65% of people surveyed get the recommended 7 hours of sleep a night. In Alabama, only 61.2% of the people get that recommended amount of sleep. Carla?
Heartburn could be linked to dementia. Now, that's according to a new study. Researchers say by stopping taking the pills, you put yourself at risk for other diseases and illnesses, including heart disease. PPIs also increase your chances of getting dementia by 44%. Meredith?
Thank you, Carla. The Mental Health Maze hotline is open until 6 o'clock tonight. We will be taking your calls. Wellstone Behavioral Center is here with the phones open. They're taking calls about anything that may be troubling you or a loved one and to help you navigate the maze of mental health. We just want to be a voice to help with any questions, as it can be kind of a difficult issue to talk about and a difficult issue to get help on. So again, 6 o'clock tonight, give us a call, 533-8609. The Mental Health Maze goes until 6. Joshua.
Thank you very much, Meredith. We do have some road closures you want to keep an eye out this morning as you head out the door. On Martin Road, the ramp that takes you on to northbound Memorial Parkway will be closed this morning between 8 o'clock and 11. Crews will be out there moving utility poles. So you see it indicated here on your map. That ramp there will be closed. The southbound ramp that takes you on to westbound Martin Road will remain open. But this, again, this is Martin Road, the ramp that takes you on a northbound Parkway, closed from 8 to 11. We also have several other road closures you want to keep an eye out for throughout the valley. In Madison, Waltriana, from Browns Ferry Road to Eastview Drive will remain closed. That work is expected to finish up today. And in Huntsville, the school zone on Whitesburg Drive is going to be expanding southward. And we also have some closures in Athens and in Decatur. See, both of those are going to be for the next few weeks. So certainly keep those in mind as well. Let's get another check on your forecast now with Liz Cosgrove.
Plenty of sunshine coming our way for today. Already kicking off with temperatures near 50 degrees out into Tuscumbia. Beautiful start to the day. And temperatures only go up from here. We'll be at 54 at 8 o'clock this morning and warming up into the mid-60s for the out to lunch forecast today. High temperatures will reach into the upper 60s to lower 70s out into the shoals for this afternoon. Mostly sunny. Just watch out for that breeze. It'll kick up from the south at 10 to 20 miles per hour. And wind gusts could reach as high as 30 miles per hour come this afternoon. But still a very beautiful day. Even walking the dog later this evening will be into the upper 60s, and then heading into tonight will stay mild into the mid 50s with clouds increasing from the west. Let's send it back over to Aaron and Justin.
Thank you, Liz. Here is one more for the road, and this is the view, and it's very special for visitors at Yosemite National Park. It's called the Firefall, and it happens only around this time of the year.
The optical illusion looks like fire is flowing off of that cliff, but park rangers say it's actually the sun glowing through the waterfall. The angle of the sun has to be just right, which happens only for a couple of weeks in the month of February.
My goodness.
That's so beautiful.
It's majestic. It really is. It looks like lava, but it's not. That's what's so amazing about it.
The sun shining right through there. Mm. And we do want to remind you, the Mental Health Maze Hotline is open right now. We want to show you those phone numbers once again to encourage you to just give us a call anytime today. We'll be open until 6 p.m. We have experts on standby from Wellstone Behavioral Health. They are ready to take your phone calls at any time from now until 6 p.m. today. And the idea is really shining a spotlight on mental health right here in the Tennessee Valley. It is 6:58, and that wraps up this edition of Way 31 Hometown News.
Good Morning America follows us in the next few minutes. We'll have more Valley headlines on our website. That's waytv.com. Have a great weekend.
Hairstyles provided by Terravaccio Salon Spa, where the difference is in the detail. And Roosters. Roosters is just like your father's barbershop, only better.
Let your floors and walls do the talking with the help of Robert F. Henry Tile. With over 50 brands of tile, Robert F. Henry Tile also carries a large selection of tile and stone made in the USA. Let our experienced design staff help you pick out the tile or stone that's right for your home.
Visit us today at 4840 Commercial Drive in Huntsville or online at henrytile.com.
For more information, click on Tennessee Valley Pros on waytv.com.
Last week, my car broke down. But keeping up with sky-high rates on payday loans was already tough. Had to fix it because no car means no job. I went to my branch of Redstone Federal Credit Union, told them about my car and payday loans. Redstone Federal refinanced my payday loans at a much lower rate and put me in a stretch loan to fix my car. If you need quick cash at the best rate, Go to Redstone, like I did.
It's Mattress Firm's President's Day sale. Shop now for huge President's Day savings. Save up to $300 store-wide. Plus, take an additional $50 off with instant savings rebates. Get Sealy Firm Queen Sets now for just $299.99. Plus, buy now and save up to $300 on our most popular Tempur-Pedic mattress set before prices go up. And sleep happy with no interest for 5 years. Only during Mattress Firm's President's Day sale.
The Mental Health Maze Hotline, Friday at 6 a.m.
Good morning, America. Heart-stopping crash caught on tape. A helicopter with five tourists on board plummeting into Pearl Harbor. New video of witnesses diving in to rescue the victims, cutting a 15-year-old free from the wreckage. Those heroes are going to join us live only on GMA.
Donald Trump versus the Pope. Those stunning remarks saying the GOP frontrunner is not Christian. Trump fires back all through the night.
No leader, especially a religious leader, should have the right to question another man's religion or faith.
And Donald Trump joins us live this morning.
Record heat building across much of the country for the weekend. Blazes sparking fire NATOs. The wind warnings and advisories spread from California to New York. That big warm-up right now.
And we have a big announcement from Ginger Z and little Adrian. She's been training for this moment for months, and now they're joining us live with news you don't want to miss. It's right here on GMA.
Live in Times Square, this is Good Morning America.
Oh, come on.
Aww.
You did too when you saw baby Adrian. Yeah. Oh, we can't wait to check in with Ginger and sweet little Adrian.
So, a big day for Adrian. Today's his two-month birthday.
2 months, yes.
Happy birthday.
Celebrate. We're going to check in with the family a little bit later, but we've got other big headlines this morning as well. The race for the White House now reaching the Vatican. Donald Trump and the Pope in a war of words. Our Terry Moran was on the plane with the Pope, and we'll get to all that in a moment.
Yeah, that was an electrifying moment. We are going to begin with that terrifying chopper crash in Hawaii. It went down with five tourists on board. A 15-year-old passenger is in critical condition this morning. We're going to talk with two men who jumped into action on the scene after this report from ABC's Kana Whitworth in Honolulu. Good morning, Kana.
Yeah, George, good morning to you. That tour helicopter, I want to show you where it crashed. It happened right